Hey guys, Surya the Science Kid back again with a brand new video. This is my third video about Phet simulator. Oh my god, my mouth. Phet simulator. If you guys don't know what Phet simulator is, Phet simulator is where all you run some simulations about, you know, simulation of experiments. In this case, we are taking a look at energy forms and changes. So I'm not gonna take a look at the intro. If you guys like this video, if you guys 3 likes, I will make sure I will do into this part where link, you know, all this stuff. If you guys see 3 likes, just 3, I will make that video come too. So let's get into the video. In the first place, I need you guys to understand what is energy. In the first place, what is energy? That's the basic question. Energy is the ability to do work. Like, you know, it's like whenever you drink bottle, you have chemical potential energy, and then you have to lift the bottle up, and then you have to use your energy to drink the water. I just drank some water. Quench my thirst, you know. It's pretty hot in Singapore, so take care, hydrate yourself, okay? Thank you. So energy is, it takes energy to cook your food, where thermal energy, you know, the gas, thermal energy, if you're using, you know, a stove, like a mechanical stove, you have to twist the thing, the thing, you have to turn it on, which is mechanical energy, which is converted into thermal energy, which is converted into chemical potential energy. Mechanical energy to twist the thing, and the thermal energy emits out the gas to heat it up, and the chemical energy is where you create your food. And it takes energy to drive to school or even jump in the air, where kinetic energy is converted into gravitational potential energy, then which is converted into kinetic energy, because you're going up takes kinetic energy, staying up in the air, gravitational potential energy, coming down takes kinetic energy. See, it takes everything needs energy to be, you know, to do things, to do work. Every single thing needs energy. So here is a very important law you have to follow in physics. It's physics. Is it physics? It's physics. Look, by the principle of conservation of energy, it says that energy cannot be destroyed, nor can it be created. It is rather converted from one form of energy to another. Also, total energy in an unisolated system is always constant. That means energy cannot be destroyed or cannot be created. It can only be stored, or it can be converted from one form to another form. For example, gravitational potential energy to kinetic energy. You know, like that. So it can never be created or destroyed. You guys have to understand that important theory or principle of law of conservation of energy. You have to memorize that thing. Okay? Yeah, let's get into the video, alright? So let's take a look at solar energy first, which is, you know, okay, so we have no clouds. That's 3. Okay, we have the energy symbols right here. 3, 2, 1, go. Now, as you guys can see, the light energy over here, which is being trapped into the solar panel, is converted into electrical energy, which is converted into thermal energy. There's the coil over here, which changes the electrical energy to convert to thermal energy. Something like your teapot, your electrical water heater. It takes electricity, heats up the water, changes it into thermal energy. As you guys can see, let's take a look at it again. As you guys can see, there you go. You guys can see, electrical energy is converted into thermal energy. The temperature also increases pretty fast. Let's take, there isn't any resistance over here. For example, if you have a lot of clouds, all of this is not, none of this are gonna hit the solar panel. Let's take each cloud as a resistance, technically like in a bulb. You know, in a bulb. If we have a bit of clouds, two clouds, only some of them come to the solar panel. Where is the sun? Okay, there you go. Some of them, only some of the light energy is converted into electrical energy, which is converted into thermal energy. So each cloud acts as a resistance. So what if we have a lot of clouds? Hold up. What if we have a lot of clouds? Three clouds. So there will be barely anything which is gonna hit the solar panel, then converted into thermal energy. Why is it increasing so fast? Hold up, wait a minute. Lots of clouds. Okay, look, the temperature is not even moving because each cloud is like changing the direction of the light energy that is deflecting the light energy from hitting the solar panel to be heated up by by this coil underneath the thing. I'm not sure if you guys can see. I'm gonna try. Okay, yeah, see, they just change their direction. So this proves that light cannot be trapped. Light, oh my god, no, my book is gone. No, okay, there you go. So this proves that light energy cannot pass through this clouds to change from, it's also a renewable source of energy. That means our sun is the light energy, right? Our sun will stay there, will be alive for another 10 billion years. That's when our sun will expand and, you know, the Earth will be swallowed by the sun. By then we'll probably move to Mars. So it will be expand and then Earth will become like Pluto. It will, the sun will expand, or maybe Earth will, number one, Earth will be Pluto, or it can be swallowed like Pluto. And then we have to move to Mars. Then its gravity just, you know, squeezes it, and then it becomes a white dwarf for another 3 million years. And then there you go. End of story, all the planets, boom, dies. That's the end of our solar system. But don't worry, it will happen in another 10 billion years. Okay, so don't you guys worry a bit. Why did I bring this topic up? Okay, so we've taken a look at this. Lots of cloud, you know, it's not even rising. So let's take a look at the cyclists. As you guys can see, no speed, no chemical energy converted into mechanical energy, which is converted into electrical energy, which is converted into thermal energy. Oh my god, that takes a lot of breath. I'm gonna take some water. Okay, that takes a lot of breath. Okay, so if we put the thing at half, some of them is converted into the sum of the energy is converted into chemical potential energy, which is converted into mechanical energy, converted into electrical energy, converted into thermal energy. And the temperature is rising pretty slowly. The rider is also becoming tired because she is losing energy. But she loses energy. She is changing the energy, but it cannot be destroyed. She is giving away. Is it the right thing to say? No. She's just converting her chemical potential energy, converted into mechanical energy, converted into electrical energy, converted into thermal energy. The temperature also rises fast. Now, let's take a look at, what if we have it at full speed? See, you have it at full speed, more chemical potential energy is converted into mechanical energy, converted into electrical energy, converted into thermal energy. She also loses chemical potential energy fast. The temperature also rises very fast. So this proves that we need chemical potential energy. The chemical potential energy also represents food, you know, our water, our nasi lemak, nasi goreng, whatever you eat during your breakfast. That's why breakfast is pretty important, because it gives you the basic energy. Is it the right thing to say? It gives you the energy to use it for the rest of the day. So, okay, so don't skip breakfast, okay? Yeah, oh my god, I'm running out of breath. Okay. Now, let's take a look at the teapot. Don't move fast. Now, let's take a look at the teapot, or whatever you want to call it, the kettle. I don't know how to call this thing, bro. See, what is this thing? Okay. So, let's put this as half beat. See, the thermal energy from the fire is converted into thermal energy. I mean, it doesn't convert, so it just moves until it turns this generator, and then it just convert this generator acts as a mechanical energy, which is converted into electrical energy, which is converted into thermal energy. Therefore, look, the temperature is also rising slowly but surely. Oh my god, my mouth, I'm so tired of talking. I mean, it's only 9:44 in the morning. I'm already tired. So what if we put at full speed? What if we put at full amount of heat? More thermal energy is converted into mechanical energy, which is converted into electrical energy, which is converted into thermal energy. And look at the temperature. It's also rising pretty fast. Pretty fast. I'm not gonna lie. It's pretty fast. So, this concludes the theory of energy cannot be created, nor can it be destroyed. So, oh my god, I'm so tired. See, the thermal energy is converted into mechanical energy. That means the heat from the fire is converted into the mechanical energy from this generator of wheel. Then this wire converts mechanical energy into electrical energy. Then this heating coil over here converts the electrical energy into the mechanical energy. That's why you guys can see this thing goes blacker. This thing goes more, you know. Yeah. See, then it stops. It just turns black. Then I don't know why, but it just goes even more blacker. But yeah, it stops. The generator stops giving out. The generator stops converting mechanical energy into kinetic energy. Then, see, it's losing temperature. Look closer, zoom in if you can. I'm not sure if I can zoom in, I forgot how to zoom in, even though I'm an IT expert. There you go. See, this proves the theory of energy cannot be created or destroyed. It can only be converted or stored in potential energy, not any other energy. It can only be stored in potential energy. Okay, I have come to the end of the video, so hit that subscribe button, okay? I know you're not. Go down there, hit that subscribe button, bro. I can see you. Right there, I can see you. Even though I'm not having my face cam yet, I can see you. I can see you. Go down there, I'll give you 3 seconds. 3, 2, 1. There you go, you've subscribed. So, peep, I've also went to this person, aka my brother. He says people who subscribe will be pros, People who like this video will be gods, and people who turn on post notifications and join my Discord are better than God. They are literally the god of gods. Technically like Zeus, you know. Yeah. God of the gods. God of these gods. No, don't convert it. Please don't increase. Thank you, Goodbye. Good boy. Is it increased? Yep, the temperature also increases a lot. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this video. So tune in for the next video. I will post it whenever I can. You know, my schedule is pretty tight. You know? Yeah. So if you don't want to miss another video, turn on post notifications, okay? Yep, and I'll see you in the next video. And adios, my dudes.